perhaps one final note?
Is it really bad yet?
For the rest of the church, choral rehearsal for the Basseterre chorale continues this afternoon at 6 p.m. And unless otherwise indicated, that will be the standing rehearsal time. Have a pleasant Sabbath and do enjoy the rest of the service.
For the cleansing, we thank you for the healing, we thank you for the restoration. against us, your people. For a day thy courts is better than a thousand. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of demons. So yes, we've come to worship and to lift you up. We thank you in advance for the blessing which we will all receive and leave here rejoicing.
From hymn number 92, this is my plan to put up.
Happy Sabbath.
Are you happy to be here?
Yes.
Yes, we are a family, the family of God.
Right.
And because we're all family, we sometimes have visits from other relatives, okay? So today, we'd like to welcome our other family, CJ from Antigua. We have Charmin from Sandy Point, SDA. Brown from KM SDA. We have Estella Anthony. She's visiting from Totola. She's a petition, but she's living in Totola now. So can you please stand, Estella, so the judges see you. We have Theodore John from Haiti, who is working here. We have Renéus Massilius from Haiti also. And we would like to make them feel really welcome, and as a family, we're going to sing our song, okay? Going together, enjoying the tribus in mutual together, okay? Going together, enjoying the trip, getting used to the family, let's spend eternity with, learning to love you, how easy it is, getting used to the family of God.
Thank you. and living in any time you turn these tithes and offerings unto you, that you may go to the furtherance of your work. Continue to bless us, we pray. And we look forward to your blessings for next year and for eternity.
Good morning.
Can a heart go free? The Bible says, and Jotham slept with his fathers, and they buried him in the city of David, and Ahaz his son reigned in his stead. Now, you may say, but what is this passage about? I don't even know why this passage was given to me this morning. But as I was in meditation, the text came to mind, the reference came to mind. And when I opened the Bible to read the reference that was impressed upon my mind, and I read it, I said, I'm not understanding this passage. But this morning, as I think about stewardship, and I think about the mercies and the goodness of God, I must say it is a joy to be alive.
Amen.
Somebody can hear that.
Amen.
I must say it is a joy to be alive. I'm taking the text not so much in relation to the theological understanding, but I'm just looking at the text for what it is. The text says that someone died and someone reigned in his stead. And today we are not dead.
Amen.
We are alive. And because we are alive, we have an opportunity to embrace God and to embrace what he continues to do in our prison experience. Our God has been a good God.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Father, we thank you for being a wonderful Savior. We thank you for your Holy Spirit who is in control. We thank you for everything you have done for us, and there's so much more that you want to give to us. But Lord, we just want to cooperate with you. We just want to work with you. Because we know that you're willing, and we give you praise, glory, and honor in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to begin by thanking Oberinda for that special music. The message being that Jesus, he meets us where we are.
Oh, yes.
And I love the fact that when we come to Christ, we come as we are. There's some of us who are tempted to say, when I come to Christ, I have to do A, B, C, D, I have to get certain things in place. But when we come to God as we are. And the Bible says that if we confess our sins, amen, that he is faithful and he's just to forgive and to cleanse us. So I love this passage. I love this song because it will address some of the areas that we will be looking at today about the fact that God will meet us wherever we are in our spiritual walk and as it relates to stewardship. I want to commend you as a congregation in our last business meeting where the treasury staff, you would have noticed most of them, they featured today in the divine service. And it's not an intentional approach to make a statement or an appeal, but it was just for participation. But I want to publicly thank the treasury, the head treasurer, Sister Alethea Clark. and the entire team for the great work that they're doing on behalf of Christ. The treasury staff and individuals who work in this ministry, they're not being paid, and the monies they're handling, it is wholly unto the Lord. And it's an awesome responsibility to manage what is holy and what God has, have mercy today. And I thank God for them and for the hard work. I want to also commend you as a church on surpassing your tithe, your expected tithe goal for this year. Amen?
Amen.
And we know that God will continue to bless us as we continue to remain faithful. There's still a little need in relation to offering, but we'll address that today. I want to speak to us specifically today on tithe. And someone may say, but why speak on tithe when you just said that we surpass our tithe goal? It's important to do good. Amen?
Amen?
But God always expects us to do better. You didn't hear me?
Yes.
I said it's important to do good, but God is a God who says that beyond what we can think about, beyond what we can give, he's willing to bless even more than what he has blessed with. So if you have one job in 2015, it's possible he will give you a second job in 2016. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Because he will give you, he will position you to give more if you're willing to give more to the glory and the honor of God. Our God is able. Now, I want to speak to us on the importance of tithe. The tithe, as it relates to the church, we encourage everyone to be faithful in tithe giving. The church manual says, as I plug in something here in relation to the manual and church officers, the church manual says one of the prerequisites for service and for those who will serve in the church are those who are faithful to God, because the faithfulness to God testifies of our spirituality. I am not here to negotiate. I am not here to defend. I am not here. I am here to make plain what the Bible has said. And faithfulness to God is a demonstration of our spiritual connection with God. I'm not the one saying it. The Bible will say it today. And as we give to God, as we grow in God, we will give faithfully to Him. Let's read from the screen now as we, and I know in many congregations we have some new converts and those who may have come a little later on. And we just want at the end of this session that everyone understands the importance of tithe and offering. And not only so, but that everyone will have a determination to give even more because our God is able to bless us. Amen?
Yes.
Amen. Let's read together. It says here the tithe is?
One-tenth.
You're not reading. Let's read together. The tithe is?
One-tenth.
One-tenth of your increase from either?
One.
That is?
Third.
Continue.
It is holy.
Yes. The Bible says that the tithe is one-tenth of the increase or produce of its money, whatever that you may have, it is returned to God. But not only that, the Bible says, and we'll read that passage a little later, it is holy and it belongs to God. Amen. It is holy, it is not ours, it is God's. And that is essential as we contemplate our tithe this morning. The biblical premise is found in the book of Genesis. We read the passage here where Abraham, the biblical reference was Abraham, but Abraham gave the tenth of his income in tithe. Let's read it together on the screen. It says, let's read from the top. I want everyone to be reading as we go through these passages this morning. Let's start together. It says,
then
Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out the bread and wine. He was priest of God Most High. And he blessed Abraham, saying, blessed be Abraham by God Most High, the creator of heaven and earth. And praise be to God Most High, who delivered your enemies into your hand. Then Abraham gave him a tenth of everything. That's the New International Version. The Bible says in this passage that Abraham had just come out of a war experience. His nephew Lot was living in Sodom, and there was a battle and there was a tension when the men of Sodom were captured. And when Abraham learned that his nephew Lot was involved, the Bible says that he got over 300 men from his family only and said, let us go and defend and to vindicate. And the Bible says that he went and they conquered with the help of the Lord. And after doing that, they would have received what is called the spoils, what you get after you've won a battle. And the Bible says that Abraham goes to the priest, and at that time they connect. And in that moment, when the priest indicates to him, praise be to the Most High God who delivered you from your enemies. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible says that in gratitude and in praise for what God would have done in his own experience, giving him the battle or giving him the victory over the battle, that Abraham gave him a tenth of everything. And we see Abraham recognizing the importance of giving and being faithful to God. One of the first biblical illustrations as it relates to tithe. Let's continue. Stewardship and money tithe. Let's read together. It says, under the leadership of Moses, the Israelites practiced the principle. Leviticus 27, 30 and 32, our scripture, we'll go back to it. Israel was asked to give the tithe. The tithe was designated to provide livelihood for the priests and for the Levites. We know that in the Old Testament and the system at that time, the sanctuary system as it relates to Israel, God allowed the tithe to be used as the individual who would have put the presentation together indicates for the priests and for the Levites. Help me here, Holy Spirit, this morning. And let us read together. The Bible says, and all the tithe of the land, whether of the seed of the land or of the fruit of the tree, is the
Lord.
It is the
Lord's,
and it is holy unto the Lord. And if any man will at all redeem aught his tithes, he shall add thereto the fifth part thereof. And concerning the tithe of the herd and of the flock, even of what